Hey, what's going on, everybody on YouTube? How's everybody doing? I'm doing just fine, doing awesome actually today. Welcome back to another little tips and tricks video here, showing you how to use some of the new nether blocks. If you guys do enjoy this video here today, let me know which of these designs is your favorite down below. And you can click the little eye up in the top right corner. That'll take you to my last two previous nether tips and tricks videos that I did here on the channel. So you guys can check those out and even get even more inspiration and designs for your nether bases, your nether block, new nether block stuff. So yeah, let's take a look at these designs. So starting off here at number one, I guess, is these little table designs using some of the new blocks that were added. And these blocks right here, this is like the warped twisted vine, which is pretty cool. It acts for a good table. It can be placed on pretty much anything, and it works as a table. And you put a little bit of carpet above it. I think it looks pretty funky. It looks like a really little, a neat and a crazy looking table design. And you know what? That doesn't look half bad. Another one here is the chains. Now, you might think of chains as sort of like a loose block, right? But if you kind of take a different light on it, you can kind of look at it as like maybe some legs for a table. It might not work particularly too well, but it's just a little idea for you. It's something that you can experiment with. I think this looks pretty neat. Here at number two, I have a bunch of different lampposts and different lighting fixtures to show you. So right here, we have this really cool sort of soul fire design using some of the warped over here, the warped planks and all that good stuff, the warped trap doors. And over here, we have the crimson trap doors with the red fire, the regular campfire. I think that looks super, super cool. We have like the chiseled blackstone block here as our base. That looks super nice. Right here, we have a little lamppost design, and then we have the altar version of that using the dual lanterns on each side. And then we have sort of the one is dangling down a little bit with the chains. And I actually kind of like this. It has a nice little almost droopy look to it. And I kind of like it. I think it looks really cool. This one is just without the chains. So, and then again, over here, it's just the single, the double. It has the single lantern using the chains. And I think this has a really cool effect to it. This might look really nice in the nether. And over here, we have the regular one without the chains. So there you go. There's some, you know, lamppost designs that you can potentially use using blackstone and the newer blocks, and it looks really, really cool. This one is probably my favorite out of a lot of the new things that have come out of this update, and that's making burnt bricks, burnt wood. You can really just apply these different blocks to these normal blocks that we have and create like almost a charred effect, or like a burnt up house or whatever, the remnants of a village raiding party. You can really go crazy with this stuff. And as you can see here, I'm using blackstone to look like this was a really hot fire at one point, and this stone has been just charred. It's black as can be, and this is what the stone brick used to look like, and now it's just been absolutely burnt up. And same over here, we're using basalt as like sort of the log has been burnt up, it's been turned to ash, and we have coal on the ground. We're using a lot of random different blocks just to show that this was once a building at one time, but it is now caught fire and it's been burnt up. And a lot of these newer blocks are able to kind of create that effect now, which is one of my favorite things with these newer blocks, is that we can create a burnt up village or a burnt up house and kind of create a story behind that, and it looks really nice. And now this design here is actually one I've done previously in the past videos, but I've decided to bring it back and add two more different forge designs that I think are going to be pretty neat and pretty unique. So right here we have the normal one, the blackstone one that I did in my first nether tips and tricks video using the new blocks and all. And as you can see here, we have the nice blackstone one. It has the nether brick up top here for like the little roof, and then it uses blackstone for the base. But over here we have just a strictly nether brick and crimson wood type of look going on here, and instead we have like a little gold in the barrel there, which looks pretty cool. So yeah, just a different variation. See the back there a little bit. And then over here we have sort of like a water forge, which I don't think you would really see typically, but it's an interesting idea if you have like an aqua base. Maybe this is how they create their weapons. Instead of using lava and the hot fires of the forge, they use the cold elements and the water and all that good stuff. And as you can see here, we're using the warped planks up top here, which I think look really cool for like a water type of base. In this next design, I'm showing you some of the lodestone features. Now, I understand that the lodestone is a pretty expensive block, okay? I understand that. But if you could, it looks great for a roof or a floor. I think it's a lovely tile floor, and I think it looks really awesome. Or like a little tiled ceiling, it looks so good. I think that's amazing. I think that's one of the best ceilings I've ever seen with one of these blocks. I just love how that looks. It just has like a nice kind of sophisticated look about it, especially for like a dining room like this. It looks really, really cool. And of course, we're using some of that crimson just to kind of add a little bit of color into this room with the chandelier, using it as like a backdrop for our windows as well. But yeah, this is mainly just showing off some of the features that you can use the newer blocks for. You can use the bottom part or the top part of the blocks as well. You don't always have to use the sides of the blocks to create something. So you can use it for roofs. An awesome floor as well. This next design is showing you that you can use the new warped blocks in combination with some of the other blocks like cyan wool to create a kind of look, a very cool looking castle roof. And you can do this with crimson as well, but a lot of castle roofs, like in the fantasy style and everything, kind of look like this. They have like these like kind of tiled layers almost. They have these like bright roofs, and I would like to see this on a very big and larger scale, but for now this looks really nice. I kind of like this. I just put this together within minutes, just putting this little castle together. And again, I would like to see it on like a larger scale castle, like the bigger roof, because then you really get the full scale of the pattern itself, like these actual tiled little layers here. And just using the warped as like a border, looks really cool. I'm really excited, especially for the warped strip stem block, because that's really gonna shine. That's really gonna look pretty good for roofs. And that's probably one of my new favorite blocks, if I had to choose one of the blocks that were my favorite. This next design is simple, but very effective. And this is basically just using chains for your wells. So instead of using, you know, the classic fence design or the iron bars, you now can use chains. And as you can see there, if we go in here, you can see that the lovely cauldron is right down there. Now the well isn't as deep because this is a super flat world, but still, you get the idea. This is a little well using chains. Finally, we can have almost a functioning well, and I think it looks really, really cool. I just love how that looks. You can even add like a little grindstone right here at the top to kind of look like a little pulley system, which would look even better. But yeah, guys, that is a little well design. I'm very excited to build wells in and throughout my villages now because we got chains. Are awesome. So for this last little bit here, I have some kind of texturing to show you, like different things that you guys can do for your builds and how, where to start when it comes to building with these new blocks. Because I will say it is a little bit of a challenge to build with these new blocks. And number one tip I give is build with them in the Nether, because they will look 10 times better in the Nether. They're made for the Nether, so build with them in the Nether. And that's where their atmosphere is truly going to shine. That dark black stone is going to shine in there. That the nether brick is going to look great. The new wood types are going to be weird and wacky in the Nether. So just to keep that in mind. But for now, I can show you some little texturing things that are going to look pretty cool. So nether brick and blackstone, oh, brother sister blocks right here. They look so good together. And with the addition of like a little bit of you know, the dark oak wood is kind of being mixed in here as well. I don't think it looks 100% good, but it does add a little bit of a difference. If you were to build this in the overworld, that's what I would kind of mix in, just add that little overworld vibe to it. And over here we have sort of like a little castle design using the same sort of blocks and just kind of figuring out, you know, what looks best. And I think this looks pretty darn swell. I really like how the nether brick and the blackstone kind of go hand in hand. So definitely something to keep in mind when building. You can also use the mix in the new wood types as well. But yeah, that's going to do it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Tell me what was your favorite design in this video today. Also, be sure to check out the other two tips and tricks videos that I did of building with new nether blocks and all that good stuff. But yeah, guys, that's going to do it. As always, don't forget to be awesome, and I will see you guys next time.